is no ambiguity, really. In our number one story in the countdown, the staff of Senator John McCain's presidential campaign has responded to Sarah Palin's book with, "Sarah Palin is a liar." The staff of Senator John McCain's presidential campaign has responded to Sarah Palin's book with, "Sarah Palin is a liar." The Palin Chronicles, described by Steve Schmidt, campaign manager, as all fiction. Described by former McCain strategist John Weaver as, quote, petty and pathetic, score settling. Sarah Palin reminds me of Jimmy Stewart in the movie Harvey, complete with imaginary conversations. That is really unfair to Jimmy Stewart and the imaginary rabbit Harvey. And from one mid-level, unnamed McCain campaign aide, quote, there are elements of truth underlying a narrative that is completely false. That aide even offering to Huffington Post emails as proof of Palin's lying. For example, on whether Palin wanted to appear on Saturday Night Live late in the campaign, in her book, Palin said, let's do this and have some fun. On Oprah Winfrey, she supported that claim, extending her enthusiasm to Tina Fey.
And then when I met her in person, oh, and the campaign was so apprehensive about allowing me to meet her, and they thought...
And to go on SNL,
oh,
Saturday
yes,
Night Live?
Yeah, they thought it was just going to be potentially atrocious, but I thought it would be fun. I wanted to participate in this because I wanted to kind of neutralize some of the parody. And,
so
and
you
I
wanted to go on Saturday Night
wanted
Live?
Wanted to, and so did John McCain.
But in an email to McCain campaign senior staffers, Palin was not thrilled with the idea. She called the SNL celebrities gross. Quoting part of the email, these folks are whack, didn't know it was as bad as it is. What's the upside in giving them, any celebrity venue, a ratings boost? More generally, Palin portrays the McCain campaign as inept and of doing a poor job of handling her. But less than a week before the election, in another email to the McCain campaign, she wrote, quote, I'm very sorry you guys are working double, triple time on this blundered up stuff that they spin because of my visits with press. But while I apologize, I say I love you guys. The Associated Press also fact-checked Palin's book, citing deviations from the full truth on 12 substantive matters. So on her Facebook page, Palin says, quote, we've heard 11 writers are engaged in this opposition research, fact-checking research. Imagine that, 11 AP reporters dedicating time and resources to tearing up the book instead of using the time and resources to fact-check what's going on with Sheikh Mohammed's trial. Colleague Sheikh Mohammed, Pelosi's healthcare takeover costs, Hassan's associations, etc. But the AP employs about 4,100 journalists, so this constitutes nearly 0.25% of its manpower. The AP also says most of the 10 guys who helped out on the story vetted only topics in the book with which their previous reporting had made them familiar, and one guy did most of the work.
And I choose to work very hard on a path for fruitfulness and for productivity. I choose not to tear down and waste precious time, but to build up this state and our great country and her industrious and generous and patriotic and free people. Life is too short to compromise time and resources. And though it may be tempting and more comfortable to just kind of keep your head down and plod along and appease those who are demanding, hey, just sit down and shut up. But that's a worthless, easy path out. That's a quitter's way out.
She was fighting with members of John McCain's senior staff, and perhaps more metaphysically, there is her war on the truth. CBS News has gotten its hands on a batch of emails that were written 3 weeks before the election. They show just how frustrated Senator McCain's staff had become with the Republican nominee's choice for running mate, and she with them. Governor Palin had become upset about a report that raised questions about her husband's membership in the Alaska Independence Party, a group whose platform calls for secession from the United States. Todd Palin had been a member of that party for 7 years, which would translate to not a member at all, given Sarah Palin's slippery relationship to the truth. Quoting from email number one from Governor Palin to McCain's chief campaign strategist Steve Schmidt, campaign manager Rick Davis, and Palin senior advisor Nicole Wallace. Please get in front of that ridiculous issue that's cropped up all day today. Two reporters, a protester sign, and many shout-outs, all claiming Todd's involvement in an anti-American political party. It's bull, and I don't want to have to keep reacting to it. Please have statement given on this so it's put to bed. Schmidt's reply to all was sent only 5 minutes later. Quote, ignore it. He was a member of the AIP. My understanding is yes, that is part of their platform. Do not engage the protesters. If reporter asks, say it is ridiculous. Todd loves America. That advice was apparently not good enough for Governor Palin. She not only replied, but carbon copied five more people on a response. That's not part of their platform, and he was only a member because independent Alaskans too often check that Alaska independent box in voter registrations, thinking it just means nonpartisan. He caught his error when changing our address and checked the right box. I still want it fixed.
I'm Governor Sarah Palin, and I am delighted to welcome you to the 2008 Alaskan Independence Party Convention in the Golden Heart City, Fairbanks. Your party plays an important role in our state's politics.
Facts that have been altered at will, and a governor who takes a minor event, overreacts, and turns it into something more menacing. Sound familiar? Schmidt's next reply would be the final word on the subject. Secession, he wrote, it is their entire reason for existence. A cursory examination of the website shows that the party exists for the purpose of seceding from the Union. That is a stated goal on the front page of the website. Our records indicate that Todd was a member for 7 years. If this is incorrect, then we need to understand the discrepancy. The statement you are suggesting be released would be inaccurate. The inaccuracy would bring greater media attention to this matter and be a distraction. According to your staff, there have been no media inquiries into this, and you received no questions about it during your interviews.
Finally, as promised, a special comment on this terrible moment in American history and those unfortunate and irresponsible Americans who have brought us to it. The America I know and love, the quitter governor of Alaska, Sarah Palin, began, is not one in which my parents or my baby with Down syndrome will have to stand in front of Obama's death panel so his bureaucrats can decide based on a subjective judgment of their level of productivity in society whether they are worthy of health care. Such a system is downright evil. Of course it is, Ms. Palin, and that is why it does not exist, has not existed, and would never, under this president, nor any other president, ever exist in this country. There is no death panel. There is no judgment based on societal productivity. There is no worthiness test. But there is downright evil, and Ms. Palin, you just served its cause. You shouted fire in a crowded theater, a hot theater, and then today tried to roll it back with, no, sorry, not fire, I meant flashlights. Too little, too late, too obvious. Madam, you are a clear and present danger to the safety and security of this nation. whether the death panel is something you dreamed or something you dreamed up, whether it is the product of a low intellect and a fevered imagination or the product of a high intelligence and a sober ability to exploit people, you should be ashamed of yourself for having introduced it into the public discourse, and it should debar you for all time from any position of responsibility or trust in the governance of this nation or any of its states or municipalities. On the staff of Senator John McCain's presidential campaign has responded to Sarah Palin's book with, Sarah Palin is a liar.